Dear colleagues, my name is Olga Vinokurova. Today we are going to talk about immunological diagnostics of tuberculosis. Firstly, let's remember about epidemiology of tuberculosis in the world. About 10 million of new cases of tuberculosis are registered every year. These are the cases of active disease with fever, cough, weight loss, or X-ray changes. However, that is not a full story, because most of infected people have latent tuberculosis. What is latent tuberculosis infection, LTBI? It is a state of persistent immune response to stimulation by Mycobacterium tuberculosis antigens without evidence of clinically manifested active TB. About one-third of the world's population has latent tuberculosis, which means people have been infected by TB bacteria but are not yet ill and cannot transmit the disease. How can anybody know if he has LTBI? Basically, it isn't even a disease, just a special condition when you have a dormant mycobacteria in your body. Immunological tests help us identify this condition. We can use these methods for LTBI detecting and performing differential diagnosis between tuberculosis and other internal diseases. Moreover, we get information about world epidemiological situation of tuberculosis. So, there are two types of diagnostics in our arsenal, skin tests and in vitro tests. All of them measure a person's immune reactivity to Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Skin tests are based on hypersensitivity reaction to tuberculosis infection after intradermal injection. The most famous of tuberculin skin tests is meant to test with 2 or 5 tuberculin units. Another one is DIA skin test with tuberculous recombinant allergen, widespread of the territory of Russian Federation and CIS countries. The similar method is developed in Denmark and called CTB test. Interferon gamma release assays, IGRAS tests, rely on the ability of T lymphocytes to release interferon gamma when mixed with antigens derived from Mycobacterium tuberculosis in vitro. Two tests approved all over the world, T-SPOT TB and QuantiFERON TB Gold. Immunologic testing is provided as a mass screening program among children in countries with high TB burden. Usually, there are the skin tests, as IGRAS are not suitable for screening because of the high cost. Besides, tests are used everywhere in groups at risk of tuberculosis. They include persons with immunodeficiency, HIV or taking immunosuppressants, household contacts of pulmonary TB, and social groups like prisoners, migrants from high-burden countries, and health workers. Now let's discuss these specific techniques in details. For tuberculin tests, traditionally used tuberculin, a glycerin extract of tubercle bacilli. Robert Koch created the first tuberculin in 1890. He assumed that tuberculin would become a treatment method. It was a mistake, but a big step into a new era of diagnostics. Later, this substance was upgraded by doctors Florence Zabert in the USA and Maria Linikova in the USSR, and named purified protein derivative, PPDS or PPDL, depends on modification. Tuberculin doesn't possess full antigen properties. It means that it doesn't sensitize a healthy organism and doesn't cause development of anti-tuberculous immunity. Specific reaction to tuberculin is possible only if the organism was already sensitized with mycobacteria as a result of spontaneous infection or BCG vaccination. At this slide, you can see technical characteristics of PPD Mantra tests is performing with. 2 tuberculin units of PPDL is considered equivalent of 5 tuberculin units of PPDS. Delayed hypersensitivity allergic reaction presents as an infiltrate around the place of intradermal injection of tuberculin in 24-72 hours. These cells and histiocytes are attracted to the site of reaction in the time frame of 1-3 days and slowly generate local inflammation, while the non-specific reaction to allergic agent fades. The procedure of intradermal tuberculin injection should be extremely accurate. Otherwise, the substance may enter deeper in the skin or leak out, and the result may fail. The second key point is the test checking. You start with skin inspect. Use good lighting, not induration or erythema in the area of injection. Then you palpate the skin. Your goal is to discover the elevation above the skin, like a spot of induration, a dense edema. Mark the edges of induration across the forearm with a pen. Measure the distance between the pen marks. Pay attention that you measure induration, not erythema. Write down the result in millimeters in the medical file. Remember, please, that it is incorrect to write only positive or negative. If you observe no induration, you should register diameter of erythema. It means controversial result. Interpretation of MANTU test has any features in different regions. Let's review the MANTU test interpretation in Russia as an example of a country with a high TB incidence. Needle mark only, negative result. Infiltrate 2-4 mm or erythema, controversial. 5 mm or more, positive. There are gradation of positive reactions. 5-9 mm mildly, 10-14 mm moderately, 15 or 16 mm strongly expressed reaction, 17 or more mm hyperurgent, an alarming sign of active tuberculosis. Look at the situations during the mass screening in children when we need help of tuberculosis specialist. First, positive reaction, 5 mm and more, non-associated to previously BCG vaccination. Increasing of infiltrate size by 6 mm or more since last year. Increasing of infiltrate size by less than 6 mm but with infiltration of 12 mm and more. Hyperurgent reaction. In these cases, you should looking for active tuberculosis by additional methods. Another protocol is used in low burden countries in people of all ages at risk. The infiltrate more 5 mm is considered positive in close contacts of infectious TB cases, HIV infected patients, fibrotic changes on chest X-rays consistent with prior TB, patients with organ transplants and receiving immunosuppressing treatment. 10 mm and more is considered positive in recent immigrants from high-prevalence countries, injection drug users, microbacteriology laboratory personnel, children under 4 years of age, infants, children and adolescents exposed to adults in high-risk categories. 15 mm and more is considered positive in any person, including person with no TB risk factors. However, targeted skin testing programs should only be conducted among high-risk groups. Tuberculin skin test is not ideal and has a weak spot. There are cross-reactions with BCG strains and some non-tuberculous mycobacteria. So, we can't get 100% specificity and clearly differentiate these conditions. Keep in mind that the person who was vaccinated or was in contact with non-tuberculous mycobacteria may have positive results of tuberculin skin test. The alternate immunologic skin test widely provided in Russia is DIA skin test with tuberculous recombinant allergen. It consists of recombinant proteins produced by a genetic modified Escherichia coli. The substance contains two antigens, absolutely the same as in IGRAS tests, ESAT-6 and CFP-10, which are present in virulent strains of mycobacteria and absent in vaccine strain. The technique of performing is identical in two tests. In 72 hours after intradermal injection, metformin can infiltrate in duration 5 mm and more in diameter. It is positive result, and we should provide additional tests and decide if there are latent infection or active tuberculosis. Okay, go next to IGRAS tests. As I said, IGRAS measure a person's immune reactivity to Mycobacterium tuberculosis by stimulating immune cells in vitro. To conduct the tests, fresh blood samples are mixed with antigens and controls. The antigens, testing methods, and interpretation criteria for IGRAS you can see in the table. In case of QuantiFERON, it measures interferon concentration. In T-spot, number of interferon-producing cells. Here is the illustration for T-spot. You can see the panels for different antigens and control samples. And if any of immunologic tests is positive and tuberculosis was excluded, we diagnose latent tuberculosis infection. Should we treat it? Yeah, in special situations, in people at risk of tuberculosis. The risk groups include people living with HIV, adults and children in contact of pulmonary TB, patients initiating anti-tumor necrosis factor treatment, patients receiving dialysis, patients preparing for organ or hematologic transplantation, and patients with silicosis. Look, consider what we know. There is a person from the risk group. Ask him if he has symptoms of tuberculosis. If no, do skin tests or IGRAS. If positive, perform chest radiography. If no, changes prescribe treatment of latent infection. If there are X-ray abnormalities or if the person has suspicious symptoms, investigate him looking for TB or other disease. Several regimen of latent tuberculosis infection treatment based on evidence. 6 or 9 months of isoniazid, 3 or 4 months of rifampicin, or both of the drugs for 3 or 4 months. Thank you for your attention. See you.